butterflies is what I feel inside. And every time it's like my first time away, and I can never find the words to say. You're the perfect girl, you were made for me. It's so easy to love you, baby. We're compatible, credible, and natural we are. And girl, I never felt this way before. From the bottom of my heart, baby girl, I just wanna tell you that you into your eyes, and I knew you were an angel, but you were in disguise. Tell me, how could I be so lucky?
The kingdom and the power and the glory
itself, is not puffed up. Love does not behave rudely, does not seek its own, is not provoked, thinks no evil. Love does not rejoice in inequities, but rejoices in the truth. Bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails, but whether there are prophecies, they will fail. Whether there are tongues, they will cease. Whether there is knowledge, it will vanish away. For we know in part and we prophesy in part.
But when that which is perfect has come, and that which is in part will be done away. When I was a child, I spoke as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child, but when I became a man, I put away childish things. For now, we see in a mirror, dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then I shall know, just as I also am known. And now abide faith, hope, love, these three, but the greatest of these is love.
Willie, I cannot promise you an easy pathway, but I can promise all my heart's devotion. A love that's ever true and growing, I love you. I love you not only for what you are, but for what I am when I am with you. I love you not only for what you have made of yourself, but for what you are making me. I love you for the part of me that you bring out. I love you for passing over all my attitudes and spoiled ways. That you know I can help. I can't help but see. I love you for drawing out into the light my beauty. Love you always and forever, Tasha.
Loving you always. Before you came,
nights are lonely days. They're just a part of my yesterday. For you I prayed forever. The love I have for you will last forever. Loving you always, forever. My love for you won't change. Girl, loving you's the best thing that I can do. You have taught me and you show me how to love again. Yes, you do. You are my best friend. So now I'm feeling so secure. So gonna make sure that this love lasts forever. We will win. We
of God and in the presence of all of you witnesses to join together this man and woman in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God in the time of man's innocency, signifying unto us the mystical union that is between Christ and his church, which holy estate he adorned and beautified by his presence and his first miracle that he wrought in Cana of Galilee. And it is commended of St. Paul to be honorable among all men. Therefore, it is not to be entered into unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. And to which holy estate these two precious persons present come now to be joined. Therefore, if any person can show just cause why they may not be lawfully be joined together, let him or her now speak, or else forevermore stay out of their business. Who giveth this woman to be married to this man?
We do.
Somebody say all of us. I want you to write. I will take the caution, be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for rich, for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, to death so do us part. According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And there too. And there too.
And there too.
I pledge thee my faith.
I pledge thee my faith.
Now. I, Latasha.
I, Latasha.
Take thee, Willie.
Take thee, Willie.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
To this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poor.
For richer, physical form.
And sickness and in health.
For sickness and in health.
And love and to cherish.
And to love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
There you go. And thereto pledge to be my faith.
And at that pledge to be my faith.
That's right. Relax. And your time that we have spent together in counseling, we dealt with a number of issues. And because of time, we don't have the time to go into and share. But three of the things most certainly we covered was true companionship, enjoyment between the husband and the wife, fruitfulness, which Pastor just prayed, and protection. You are her protection and her protector. She is the protector of your home. You both are the protectors of your children. And you only can do it with the help of God. And he has promised you, with him all things are what?
Possible.
But without him you can do. So we place all that also into your pledge today. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Yes, sir. These beautiful ring covered in diamonds and a biggie on the top and the pawn shops across the street. But the one thing about this ring, if it's silver or gold, that it is a complete circle. There's no crack or crease in it. It's complete. The ring that he's going to place on her finger represents completeness. They can't complete one another. Only God can do that. But they're no longer two. They become what?
One.
And it's a demonstration of that pledge. Won't you please? With this ring, I thee wear, and with all my worldly goods, I thee endow, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Same thing, it's just bigger. Bigger means more responsibilities. But it's still a complete circle. And it's completeness in your marriage. It's a vow. God, right? Yes.
With this ring,
I thee wear.
I thee wear.
And with all my worldly goods.
With all my worldly goods.
I thee endow.
I thee endow.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And the Son.
And of the Holy Ghost.
And the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. O eternal God, creator and preserver of all mankind, giver of all spiritual grace, the author of everlasting life, send thy blessings upon these thy servants, this man and this woman, whom we bless in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. That these persons may surely perform and keep the vow and covenant between them made, and may ever and live according to thy law. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Can the congregation say amen?
Amen.
To those God hath joined together, that no man, nor woman, nor anything put it asunder. And I believe you all understand what all that means. If it's being translated from the Greek of the Bible, All it's saying, if you don't have something good, something positive to share with this couple, don't share anything.
Amen. That's right.
Amen. Amen.
They're not getting married to bear our drama. God forbid they're going to have drama of their own.
Yes, Lord.
They don't need to solve our problems. Jeremiah 33 says, call God, he will answer.
That's right.
If you don't have anything good to say to them, it's best that you what? Say nothing at all.
Say nothing.
So as much as willing, and Natasha have considered together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God in this company, and thereto have pledged their faith to each other and have declared the same by joining hands, I pronounce that they are husband and wife together in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
It's a desire that this couple has for all of us. And that is, and I know it's many of you here that are, and that you do. But this couple desires that everybody here has a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
That's not promising you that every day is going to be a bed of roses. But one thing it does promise you, that you have hope. And if you don't know anything else, let me share this one thing to you, and we ain't preaching. The only hope we have right now is in Christ Jesus. Amen. I know some of you all think you got it all. You know, it's all, y'all did it. You woke up yourself. You dressed yourself. You made your job. You went wherever. You got it all. I don't want to bust your bubble. But I will tell you, it ain't so. Amen.
Amen.
So I'm not going to ask how many of you are saved, how many of you are giving your life to the Lord. I'm going to do as the Lord has told me to do. Give you a choice and a freedom to join in this prayer. And if you want to do that, most certainly. But the main thing that you got to do after you pray this prayer, if you give your life to the Lord, you must tell somebody. When you leave here, you got to tell somebody, on this day, I gave my life to the Lord. As sure as I'm standing here, my brothers and sisters, the adversary is waiting outside the door to let you tell you you ain't done nothing. Well, once you pray this prayer and you mean it from your heart, you are now in the position to tell the devil. If you don't want your children here, cover their ears. You're now in a position to tell the devil to go to hell. You ain't got no business going to hell. Hell was created for him. So you are now in a position to tell the devil to do what?
Go to hell.
So if you will, would you pray this prayer with me? Lord Jesus,
Lord Jesus,
I confess that I am a sinner.
I confess that I am a sinner.
I turn from my sins.
I turn from my sins.
And my own righteousness.
And my own righteousness.
I turn to you.
I turn to you.
I believe that you died for my sin.
I believe that you died for my sin.
And rose from the dead.
I rose from the dead.
For my justification.
For my justification.
I place my trust in you.
I place my trust
as my personal Savior.
As my personal Savior.
And I receive you into my heart.
And
as Lord and Master of my life.
Help me to follow you.
As I accept your free gift
of
eternal life.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, you gotta tell somebody. Each one of them have lit a candle on the right and on the left of the Christ candle. Now that one candle that they lit, they're now going to blow it out. Now together, light the one candle. They're lighting this candle together, symbolizing other lives as the one light that cannot be divided. It is our prayer for this couple that in their lives nothing will divide them by any means, in Jesus' name. And the Lord God counseled a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh thereof. And the ribs which he had, God had taken from him, made he a woman and brought her out unto the man. And Adam said, "This is now bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. Therefore shall a man leave his father and mother and shall be permanent unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh." Amen?
Amen.
May your marriage bring you all the fulfillment a marriage should bring. And may the Lord give you patience, tolerance, and understanding. May it be full of joy and laughter, as well as comfort and support. May you discuss the true depth of love through loving one another. Remember that every burden is easier to carry when you have the shoulders of two instead of one. When you are weary and discouraged, look to Jesus to refresh and strengthen you. May you always need one another, not so much to fill your emptiness as to help you know your fullness. May you always need one another, but not out of weakness. Rejoice in and praise one another's uniqueness. You are both individuals with your own personalities. Don't lose that. All the time I've known you, you laugh, you smile. If the Lord let me live to see you 20 years from now, I hope to see the laugh and you still smile. I ain't saying you're not going to hit it a couple times, but Joe. For God is the creator of both of you, your differences and in your personality. Be faithful to one another in your thoughts and your deeds. And above all, be faithful to Jesus Christ. For he is the author and the finisher of your faith. The love of God, the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you today, now, and forevermore. In the name of the Father, the Son, Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name, you may kiss your bride. It is my joy to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Willie James Johnson.
Those were the words I said to you. It was last night. Yeah. time begins again.
Latonya Booker and Mr. James Jones. Patty Jones and Mr. Charles Booker. Mrs. Carl Perry and Mr. Evan Jones. Mrs. Aaliyah Wooten and Mr. Tony Williams. Uriah Johnson, Ms. Alexis Simmons and Mr. Simeon Johnson. Miss Letitia Kitchen Thompson. Mrs. Chanel Braxton. Kenneth Foote. Miss Nevaeh Ingram and Miss Malia Jennings. Mr. and Mrs. Willie J.
Man, I love y'all. You know, hope y'all be together forever with my niece and nephews. And I know I see y'all. I know Angel behind me doing something stupid, but it's all good.
Tasha and Willie, congratulations.
Thanks, guys.
Willie, welcome to the family, sir. Hope you guys have many years of great marriage. We'll continue to pray for y'all and just be here for y'all if you need us. But most importantly, we'll be over for every cookout, every birthday party, and, you know, to eat up all the good food. So we'll see y'all later. Have a good one.
Tasha, you look beautiful.
Tasha, Mom Tracy, I love you. Willie, congratulations. I love y'all. And may God bless this unity forever, forever. I love you with all my heart and soul.
God, Mommy, and God, Father, I love y'all very dearly. And congratulations. I hope y'all have a happy life.
Congratulations, Tasha and Willie. And many, many more in blessings. Cousin Jackie.
Hi, Tasha. It's Uncle Gary and Aunt Nancy. I hope your marriage is as happy as mine and Gary's is. Congratulations. We love you.
Love you, buddy. Hi, Tasha and Willie. Congratulations on your very great big commitment. I wish you guys the best of luck and welcome to the club.
Hey, Tasha and Willie. Love you. Congratulations from Team Takeover. Yay! We love you. Many, 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 many blessings.
See you through.
You know we love y'all. Y'all been together since I've known you. I'm glad you finally made that commitment, sir. I got you, bruh. Don't worry about it. It's not as bad as it seems. And I hope you all are together forever and all of that great stuff. And I can't wait to come over and cook out at your house. Love y'all. Peace.
Hi, Willie and Tasha. We love y'all. Glad y'all got married. It's cheaper to keep her.
You're so good,
man. Hey, Tosh. It's OG girl. Congratulations and many, many more.
Hey, my diva. I love you. I love you too, Willie.
Hey, Tosh and Willie. It took y'all some while to get there, but you can say God bless you, and you finally made it. Remember your vows and don't let no man or woman come between you. Keep that life that y'all have always had, and you know you'll have a good one. Stay close to God and you won't have to worry about anything. God bless y'all.
I guess I will see. Hey, Tasha. Hey, Willie. Congratulations. We love you. I'm so excited that you all are married and now Tasha's really my cousin. Yay. Love you guys. Congratulations.
Congratulations, sister and brother. I pray that y'all have so many years of happiness and that God bless y'all union every day. Congratulations.
Congratulations to Tasha and her husband. I wish you many years of happiness. Y'all are a lovely couple.
Tasha and Willie, I wish y'all happiness, love, everlasting, and all that.
I wish both of you the best that life has to offer. You two are beautiful, beautiful people. And I wish you nothing but the best of happiness. And so what you got to say? We on camera. I guess he can't speak because he's here with all of this.
We love you all. We hope, you know, oh, that's true. But we got this.
We got this. Yeah.
Tosh and Willie, I wish y'all happiness, love, everlasting, and all that good stuff.
Congratulations, Sister Tasha and Brother Willie. It's about damn time y'all made it legal. Hello.
Simmons and Willie, I like to say congratulations, and it's about time, and I love both of y'all, and I wish y'all the very best.
Hey, sis, you know I love you so dearly. Just wishing you guys the best and a lifetime full of happiness. Hey, Willie, welcome to the family, although you've been a family for a long, long time. Okay, love you guys much. Smooches.
for my little niece. Tears came down my eyes when I saw her come down the aisle with my brother. I thought about her when she was a little girl. And I used to keep her a lot when she was growing up as a little girl. And now to see her as a full-grown woman with children of her own and being a mother, a wife, I'm very proud of her. And congratulations, and I love you. And you know you can always still come to Aunt Pam whenever you need anything.
I like to say congratulations to my cousin Tasha and my new cousin Willie. May they have many, many years of blessings together. Thank you.
Listen, I think I see it again, see it again, see it again, see it again.
My name is Kenny. I'm Willie's best man, as you know. I know Snoop for a long time. Long time. I was a little tight.
Don't call me that.
I've known him for a long time. But, you know, I'm happy for him and Tasha. They've been through the ups and downs. I've been here for a whole lot of them, so I get it. But I am happy for him. I know he is happy, and I definitely know for sure. As much as she might try not to admit it, she's really happy too. But honestly, just from the bottom of my heart though, I just want to just tell them both I love them. My two little nephews, you know what I'm saying? I love you though, dog. I love you. You know what I'm saying?
Kenny, you forgot to leave.
Oh yeah, and little Lex, my little niece over here, love her to death. I said you nephew. Okay, so nah, seriously though, but everybody, like the Reverend said earlier, if you don't have nothing positive to say, don't say nothing at all. That's true, you know. But you, also just try to give them words of encouragement when you can. Anybody in here that is married, you get it. It's not easy. Lord knows that I know. It's not easy. It's not easy. So whenever you get a chance, if it pop in your mind, I know a lot of y'all don't see them that often. I see them a lot of y'all don't see them that often, but if it ever crosses your mind, just give them a call, ask them how they doing, give them a couple words of encouragement. And this is JC for my man. He likes the cognac, so just slide through, give him a bottle. Nah, but seriously though, man, cups up, cheers to the groom and bride, Mr. and Mrs. Johnson. Okay.